In the 1960s, the hip-jerking, gyrating Mick Jagger and the rest of the Stones were every parent's nightmare. Don't you worry about what's on your mind, oh.
Stones embodied sort of unbridled sexiness, and the establishment were terrified of them. They represented drugs, they represented sex and excess.
They were regarded as the bad boys of British pop. So you had the Beatles on one side, you had the Stones on the other.
With a raunchy reputation to live up to, in 1967, the Stones came up with a soon-to-be notorious song, which would reach number 3 in the UK charts.
I think what we have to realise now about Let's Spend the Night Together is it was a thoroughly revolutionary track at the time.
Think about it. It's just Mick going, fancy a shag. This record captures the zeitgeist moment. The zeitgeist moment being free love.
The 1960s were a time of experimentation, a time of relative permissiveness, and the Stones record reflected rather than shaped what was happening.
The single hit the charts as millions of young Brits were getting used to the thought of the freely available pill, and a relaxation in the abortion laws.
MPs have spent nearly 64 hours and spoken more than 500,000 words debating it.
Girls were suddenly able to explore their sexuality in a way that they hadn't been able to 10 years or a generation before. Let's Spend the Night Together was just in the right place at the right time with the right message.
With their new record riding high in the hit parade, it was time for the Stones to take their direct message across the pond.
The song Let's Spend the Night Together was controversial in the States because talking about casual sex between consenting adults was just unheard of at that time.
Keen to capture the biggest American TV audience possible, the band were booked to appear on The Ed Sullivan Show. But things didn't go according to plan.
We had a big confrontation with Ed Sullivan and the producers. The heat started when they didn't want Mick to sing Let's Spend the Night Together. It was 2 hours of no, 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 you can't sing the song. Then it became, all right, you can change it and sing Let's Spend Some Time Together. I didn't think they were going to go along with it. But finally, Mick relented and said, okay, we'll sing Let's Spend Some Time Together.
I witnessed it, you know, live, in flesh, right in front of me. You could see that he wasn't taking himself that seriously, and he was just kind of going along with it.
Mick rolled his eyes to show how ridiculous he thought it was.
The audience just ate it up. It was a spectacular performance.
He was just sexy because I think the way he gyrated, that was, remember, this was a time originally when they were banning Elvis Presley from swinging his hips.
For millions of women, it's about young Mick Jagger, isn't it? It's about those rubber lips. It's about his kind of frantic electric chicken groin, you know, that jerkiness and his youthful beauty and his flowing locks.
Some sex gods come from really surprising origins, and a lot of the rock sex gods are skinny little guys with a good brain on them, a great sense of humor and a turn of phrase, but really they're not guys who would get a second glance in the street, and then they transform themselves through their music.
Barely a woman alive, I think, who hasn't had a fantasy about young Mick Jagger. You know, really, you're just saying, yes, please ask me, Mick. Yes, I would, back then.
So, at number one, it's the oldest track on our list from a group whose popularity spans all 5 decades. The Stones may be the oldest swingers in town, but they clearly know how to shake it.